I will present this joint paper with my colleagues, and these are fellow colleagues that are also involved in the EPS program. So I will talk a little bit about the program itself, and then how a little bit more in detail about our own implementation, how we implemented the European Project Semester at ISEP, a little bit about the biomimetic projects, and finally we'll draw some conclusions. So in terms of background, let us see where EPS stands. EPS is a Capstone project internship program, and so it is an essential part of an engineering program curriculum, and it is at the top. The program itself was devised by a gentleman, Professor Arvid Andersen, in Denmark in 1995. And the goal that he had originally was to foster the development of competencies in engineering graduates, namely project organized learning, teamwork, development of complementary transversal skills. This is all done within one semester, a project-based learning semester, and is intended for students from diverse backgrounds in terms of nationalities as well as scientific backgrounds. I've seen European project semesters that involve typically engineering, product design, and business students. The European project semester is provided by a network of European schools called the EPS providers, and we are currently a group of 16 schools, engineering schools. We are scattered through 12 European countries. We started in the program here in 2011, and we've been running the program since then. So far, we have included in the program 90 students. Those correspond to almost 20 teams from 14 countries. And the diversity in terms of scientific backgrounds is big, so we've had 22 different types of graduates involved. In particular, in the case of EPS, with this slide it's not probably very clear, but it is the origin of the students we've received so far. Our implementation here at ISEP of the program follows the so-called golden rules of EPS, which you can check on the provider's site. The link is available on the paper. And although all providers follow those rules, each provider always contributes with a different flavor. And so I will present our implementation here at the school. So the program itself is structured around a main module, which is the project module, and it accounts for 20 CTS. This is the core of the program, and then we have five complementary modules, but they do not survive by themselves. They are just project-supported modules. When a team is working, apart from the Portuguese, okay, forget, okay, that is always the foreign language, apart from the Portuguese, all other topics are topics that only exist as a companion to the project. So if the students are working in ethics and deontology, they will be working focused on their own project. What are the impacts of the ethical concerns? What are the deontological aspects that are related to their own project? This is implemented roughly following this schedule. So the program is a 15-week program. We have 3 milestones. The first milestone corresponds to the end of the team building activities, and the teams have to agree on a set of rules on how they govern their own teamwork. Then at the middle of the semester there is the interim presentation, and they have to present a set of deliverables, and finally at the end they will have to present their work and also a collection of deliverables. We'll go through that in a minute. The energy and sustainability, ethics and deontology and marketing are modules, project supported modules, that are finished around the half of the semester. Only communication, foreign language and project management go along with the project itself. How do we build the teams? We are receiving applicants from several origins, countries and schools, and they don't know each other, we don't know them as well, and we cannot expect them to somehow aggregate. Okay. So what we do is, first we apply one of the golden rules, which is the states that it is mandatory that each team has at least 3 different nationalities and 3 different scientific backgrounds. And then we ask the participants to fill in the Belbin test, and then our psychologists, then they come out with their teamwork profiles, and then we try to match them as best as possible. The rules that we apply to our proposals here in ICEF are those two. They should be multidisciplinary and they should be open problems. That is, no solution is provided within the requirements. It is fully open. And I have there a list of some of the projects that have been offered during the period that we have been providing EPS. In particularly, I am highlighting the ones that are related with this presentation, which are the biomimetic project proposals. In terms of space and tools that we use, of course we use standard tools, supportive tools. There's a dedicated room for all EPS activities, for the lectures. The teams can use the room 24 hours, 7 days a week, and it's there that they should do the bulk of the project development. We use Moodle and Dropbox, of course, and then everything that has to do with the management of EPS, we use the Google ecosystem. A very important tool here for our EPS projects is the wiki. The wiki is not only it works as a collaborative tool for the team and for the supervisors, but as well it stays as a showcase of the projects that have been done throughout this period. As you can see, the staff is not a very large staff. We are as well as diverse as possible, so we are coming from several different departments, and that is the total amount of work per semester that is distributed with the support of the International Relations Office. The 6 teachers provide support for the complementary modules, and the 7 on the top are the ones that act as supervisors. Our approach here at ISEP has a distinctive feature, which is the supervision is a joint supervision model, where the 7 teachers stay in the room each week
and meet with the teams and discuss. So there will be a team of students and there is a team of supervisors. So it is like a rugby match. The assessment, the students do their self and peer assessment, and the teachers from the complementary modules also provide feedback, as well as the supervisors. For any kind of conflicts, we will apply the team rules that were defined in the team agreement milestone. And there is a wide variety of deliverables that the students or the teams should hand in. Of course, the wiki, there is an example of the wiki on the right side. They should hand in an intermediate as well as a final report, an intermediate and final presentation, a video, a poster, a brochure, a paper, and a manual. And let me make here a parenthesis. For example, the papers that we have submitted to the conference are based on the students' papers. Of course, there was, let us say, a little bit of work on top of it, but it is always best to start with something than nothing, otherwise we wouldn't have also the time to do it. So, but the papers that we have produced here in the conference are based on the student papers. Of course, everything is online on the wiki, you can check it. I can just show you an example, if this works, okay. And this is the, so regarding the project proposal, you can see how open the project proposal is. You have there that they should develop and implement a biologically inspired swimming robot. And the project requirements are reuse of, let me check, I can't see it here. Okay, reuse existing components on the low-cost hardware, open source solutions, it should have a power autonomy of 12 hours, and it should comply with the following EU directives. The machine directive, the electrical safety directive, and the hazardous products directive. And follow mandatorily the international system of units. These are the requirements that the students should fulfill. Everything else has to be decided by the team through brainstorming and also by themselves and together with the supervisors. Okay, this is the how this is done. Let me find the cursor here. And if you want to take a look at the deliverables, this is the set of deliverables that they have produced, okay? So the interim, the leaflet, the final report, presentation, paper, poster, video, and the user's manual. Okay. Let us proceed. So this is a graph of the diversity and the number of the students that we've been having. And finally, let me share with you that the EPS is compliant with the conceive, design, implement, and operate framework for engineering programs. Because on the conceive and design stage, we do all those things. It's what the students do till the mid, the interim assessment. So they have to do all those things. They should look into the sustainability, the project management, the marketing, the state of the art in the area where they are developing their project, and all those things should be taken care of. And this results in the interim deliverables and the presentation, as well as the bill of materials. The students must come up with a bill of materials to implement then on the second part their prototype. And then on the second part we have the implement and operate with the assembly, the testing and debugging, and finally the validation. It culminates with the final presentation and the handing of the deliverables, and as well as the product prototype. So how do the bio-inspired robots fit into the picture? They fit, and we'll see how they'll fit, because they are extremely appealing to students as a topic. okay? And they also allow, they are multidisciplinary by nature, so they allow the integration of the different know-hows of the team members. We have these two projects, the swimming robot and the flying robot, both from 2014. And you can see the constitution of the teams. You'll see that they are from different fields as well as different nationalities. And as an example of the CDIO implementation, they all first developed the design, they conceive and come up with a design, and then they move into the implementation of a prototype. What can we say about the feedback that we have from the teams? They clearly see it as an active learning approach. For example, they say that we have learned a lot from this project and we can draw conclusions from our experiences. This is quite rewarding for a teacher, I'd say. They can also give us clues about why this type of projects is interesting. We like the biomimetic approach of the task. Then they say that this is why we want to try to discover the principles behind, mimic them, and apply them to man-made craft. And as well as some other testimonials regarding how they perceived the multidisciplinary teamwork, or how the project raised their eco and ethical awareness. And this is regarding the swimming robot project. And the same occurred with the flying robot team. I will not go into much details into the projects themselves, because in this session we will have two presentations, one regarding the flying robot and the other regarding the swimming robot. So I am just here sharing with you what are the feedbacks that we got from the teams regarding this type of approaches. So I will come to the conclusions, and if I have the time, I will show a little video, one of the videos made by the students. Okay, that fits into the future. Okay, so what can we conclude? First, that EPS is a program, a project-based learning program for conducting capstone and internships in engineering. The main features of this program is that there should be as much diversity within the students as possible. Complementary skills are a must. The proposal should be as open and multidisciplinary as possible so that every team member can contribute and they can decide their own design and find their own solution. And in the case of EPS at ISEP, we implement a joint supervision model, which we are very satisfied with. I think it has been very rewarding for us as supervisors, because we didn't have that experience to work together with colleagues. And so I think it is one of the things that keep us working on this program, because it's not because of anything else. EPS usually comes as an additional task that we must do on top of all other tasks that we do. So, the biomimetic proposals, why choosing this type of projects? Because above all, they are extremely challenging for the students. They provide inspiration and they keep them motivated. They are by nature multidisciplinary, and they also contribute to raising the awareness of the students in terms of ecological and ethical concerns. So I think I will come to the video.